Age of Mythology Retold has brought some new technologies to the game and reworked some of the old ones, and they have some pretty cool effects now. I'm going to go through some of my favourite ones, and if you haven't heard of these, I really suggest trying them out. First off, we're going with Valley of the Kings, which is probably my favourite upgrade in the whole game now. The upgrade from Thoth causes barracks and Migdal stronghold units to spawn an additional unit when it's empowered by the Pharaoh. This is basically an elephant printing machine. If you have your Pharaoh on the Migdal stronghold, you get two elephants for the price of one. It also works for barracks units, but you'd be a fool to not use it for elephants and anything from the Migdal stronghold, especially as Thoth also gives you an extra elephant upgrade as well. Thoth's elephant upgrade makes them cheaper, less population, and does more damage. If you combine these, it's just insane value. Cheaper elephants, and you get two. And they're better. What's not to like? Next is Rig's Thula. This is a brand new Heimdall technology, which increases training and research work rate by 20%. This works for villagers, this works for all units, and it changes Heimdall from purely a rushing minor god into one where you can just sit back and make the most of this. If both players sit back at one town centre, then you'll just be ahead. The only thing is it does cost 20 favour, so what I did here is I chanked the goats up until I got 20 favour, but making sure not to kill them off, as to not lose them. This is a trick I learned from watching Soup's stream. Sarissa from Athena has added tech to it now. It still gives the hoplites plus 10% attack, but it also lets them have a bit of range. If you have a large group of units, it allows the ones at the back that wouldn't be attacking normally to attack due to their range. It might be quite hard to tell what's going on in mass, but if you see them one against the other, you can really see that they have a lot more range than normal. In small engagements, it ends up being pretty close, but as soon as you have multiple of them, the ones with extra range just win by a landslide. There's a lot of myth unit upgrades, but my favourite new one is Jotun's. This is an upgrade for the Mountain Giant, and the Mountain Giant is now just huge. He gets extra HP, extra speed, and another ability, being able to punt units. It's great to just be able to kick villagers out the way, and it does a lot of damage. The next upgrade is an Ares upgrade, which allows you to get Hippaspis in the Classical Age. It also gives them 15% extra attack bonus, like it did before, but it means that you can get them in the Classical Age rather than having to wait till Heroic. As Hippaspis are pretty good in Retold, this is a really good technology, great against a civilization like Norse that wants to spam out those infantry units. It's also better than having a technology that you can't use until the Heroic Age. I think it makes perfect sense. We've now got some Lifesteal upgrades. They word it really weirdly though. Instead of calling it lifesteal, they say they heal for X percent of damage by all actions against a unit. Really wordy way of just saying lifesteal. So Crimson Linen, the Sekhmet upgrade, gives you 20% lifesteal for all myth units, 60% lifesteal for scarabs. So now scarabs just have insane lifesteal. You can really see this in a 1v1. There are other upgrades with lifesteal though. Thracian Horses is a Dionysus upgrade that now gives your cavalry 20% lifesteal. For a unit like Cavalry that have a lot of HP, this is a great upgrade for them. Another lifesteal is from Tyr, this is Berserker Gang. This now gives Berserks 35% lifesteal, and 35% lifesteal is so much. Obviously they don't have as much health as the Cavalry, but I think this is still a solid upgrade. Now an Atlantean upgrade, Sons of the Sun. Hyperion converts all oracles to heroes, and any newly trained oracles will be heroes. This is just a nice little upgrade, which basically just allows you to get more favour. If you get all your oracles out, then it's basically like you're having 10 Egyptian monuments worth of favour gather rate. You can see the favour just goes up so much. Probably not the craziest upgrade, but I just like how they've given a little something extra to the new way that Atlanteans gather favour. The next couple here are new technologies where as you lose health, something happens. The first one is Axe of Vengeance, which still gives the Axemen extra damage against buildings, but it also gives them extra attack for each percentage of HP they're missing. Now for Axemen, maybe this isn't the best because they don't have much HP, but as they're being attacked, they can obviously do a bit more damage to buildings, so I definitely won't say no to it. But the more interesting one though is an Atlas upgrade called Devotees of Atlas. This is for fanatics, and it's a bit of a strange one. So for each 1% of HP they're missing, they get more speed and more rate of fire. So they attack faster and they're faster. This is a bit of a strange upgrade, but fanatics have a ton of HP, so this is definitely worth it. You can see here how he just runs away and you just get so much more speed. I don't really know how the best way to utilize this is, because if you've got a whole army of them, you're probably moving them around together anyway. but the extra rate of fire for attacking is definitely worth it. And if you get one low HP, maybe you can micro that one around. That's probably the best way, but it's going to be quite hard in the middle of a fight, I reckon. Especially as this is going to be in the late game when you're going to have so many units. The next section here is all about divine damage. Divine damage, in Retold, is basically true damage from any other game. It ignores all armor values and does the set rate. So these are three versions of this. Two of them are poison versions. So what they do is when they attack, they leave a green poison on the enemy, which is a dot of damage over time of X amount. Whereas the upgrade for the Hoplites just gives them one additional divine damage on top of their already existing attack. This is basically increasing their DPS by one whole damage that can't be stopped by armor. I'm not sure which one's better, whether the damage over time or just the flat rate. I guess we're just going to have to find out, but probably the flat rate. As the enemy, you can see when you're poisoned, so that would be something where you would pull those back, I think. Lastly, we have an upgrade for the Hydras and the Scyllas. So this is again a Dionysus upgrade. This gives your Hydra and Scylla regen. Now, Hydras in Retold are just so good anyway. It's something where when I've been playing the campaign, I've been loving using them, and this just gives them a little something extra. There are so many other upgrades that have either been changed or new ones, but these are my personal favourite ones. If you have any favourite ones that I didn't mention, put them in the comments below. And I'll see you in the next one.